And now, The Bonfire with Big J Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Thursday,
oh,
which
good.
Means it is the Lost Tapes.
Yeah.
It's the Bonfire.
The Frankenstein of the Bonfire.
Frankenstein.
I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson. This is Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. Lost Tapes episode.
Dude, I was just laughing. I wanted my cheeks are still hurting from stopping. The George Lopez Netflix hour.
Is it Netflix or HBO? It's HBO? Here, grab the mic, Jacob.
It's new? It's brand new?
Oh, there you go. Oh!
It's called The Wall, yeah.
It's brand new?
Yeah, it's brand
and
new.
And it's an HBO special?
It aired live last week.
Oh, my God. Is that just a straight hour of like...
Yeah, he's my favorite...
Latino kid had it pretty rough. Not like you, El Blancos.
All right, here's the trailer. Drop the marionette.
I'm back. I got a brand new HBO comedy special, and it is live. Washington, D.C. Lots changed since the last time I was here. So I'll be addressing the most important social issues facing our country today. Like, how organic is organic?
For white people?
He goes, white people like, I don't know what organic is.
It's an hour.
I don't
really?
Know. I'm unaware of... I don't know. Is that queso organic or is it... I don't know.
Yeah.
Am I supposed to know, gringo?
Yeah. Shut up, stupid. And you're like, oh. White people should just... We should talk like this all the time. We should do George Lopez white people voice for an entire hour.
I think that would be wonderful. And then the Latino come in.
Mira. No.
please finish the trailer.
The rise of newer and even more exotic sounding food allergies. Oh, yeah. And this.
Does he have a lot of... Jacob, he's smashing a wall. I should tell you that. At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. He said, and this, and it was the wall, and it's him smashing it. Jacob, you watched the whole hour. Does he have a lot of Trump stuff?
Yeah.
He does? Okay. So I thought, like, I don't like when they do that, and then it's just one half joke.
This goes very much in line with another thing we wanted to talk about, and I will say this here. Here's what I've heard George Lopez interviewed a bunch of times. Sounds like an all right dude.
Yeah.
Sounds like a pretty good dude.
I'm a George Lopez fan. I liked the George Lopez show a lot.
I never watched it, but I don't dislike him. I'm not super into the, from what I've seen of his, like, comedy ultimately, but who gives a shit? That's my opinion.
Mm-hmm.
Where I'm taken back by here is his agreeing to do what he's doing here, putting on goggles and a suit and breaking a wall with a sledgehammer. It's just...
Well, who's to say it wasn't his idea?
It probably wasn't his idea.
You don't think so?
I mean, like, he came up with it with somebody, probably. But just, you know what I'm saying?
George,
like, how weird you have to feel doing that? Like, where's the shame in just being dude, I can't.
Well,
like, other comics are going to go, like, are you really making a thing of you breaking a wall?
Yeah, but I was trying to get to that meeting where he got pitched it, because I don't really know if that's his idea. You're right. Play the rest of it. Yeah, it's just him smashing the wall.
Should really tune in. It's gonna be very satisfying.
Yeah, dude. I mean,
I wonder if his business partners have the white guy voice that he does. Where they're like, George, you should smash a wall.
By the way,
my business partner would be all like, George, what if I told you to crush a wall?
And I was all like, see.
That's how, what if he, he recaps his meeting to his like family when he comes home? He's like, how's work today? He goes like, man, you know, Latinos, we're different, man, you know? We're in the boardroom, we're like, orale, ese. And then like, white people come in, they're like, George, good afternoon, how is everything? I'm all like, I'm good, man, what's up?
Why? Like, what do you think?
Yeah, they're like, well, we want you to smash a wall. I'm like, mira. I'm honey. That's the eyeballs.
I'm very
that's this, because, you know, as a comic, you try to be as close to who you are offstage, onstage. So it's funny to think of him offstage as that George Lopez. Where he's like Sebastian offstage as Sebastian.
Like just, really doing that?
Yeah, would just be intolerable.
What do I want to order?
Yeah, they go.
Do you have halibut?
Like, buddy. Hey, this is the north side of Chicago. Quit it with the fucking head nods. You know when he hits his head? Yeah. I fucking look at the guy I'm like.
No, here's the thing. I just think George Lopez, I mean, he, listen, he has to co-sign whatever it is he did. I'm just surprised he wanted to do that. I have been talked into with minimal effort, way doofier things.
Yeah.
In my career, but I was at an age where I'm like, I don't know, okay, if you say so. I have headshots that still float around with me holding, a sledgehammer.
Yeah. It's, oh, maybe. Is that why?
Was it why it hits me so hard?
Yeah. Is maybe. That why it hurts? You're maybe. Like, oh, I went down the sledgehammer route.
Maybe it wasn't, the reason.
It wasn't for a wall dividing Mexico and the United States. It was more of a butthole joke, but.
Wait, can you keep playing sledgehammer while you play Felipe Esparza comedy over under it?
I've been translating my whole life. English to Spanish. Spanish to English. I'd rather be bisexual than bilingual.
What, is this a new HBO special coming too? Is it Hispanic Heritage Month or something? What's happening?
No, but they clearly played his in front of George Lopez's because it's...
No, but I feel like is it Hispanic Heritage Month one of these months?
Wait, when did George Lopez's come out? This week? Oh, there's the picture. Jay yeah. with the hammer.
Oh, hell yeah.
Those lovely locks.
I'm not bragging. Man, I really have like a hand job in all my pictures anyway.
And a Jaeger shirt on. That's the impressive part.
Tell you what, that Kiss picture, I look okay.
Which Kiss picture?
Right to the upper right of that stupid picture that's there, yeah.
Yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
Now. Little fat rolly.
Do you miss the long hair?
Sometimes. Not really, though.
Are you ever going to go that long again?
Maybe. If I lose a lot of weight.
Then you go long.
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't want to be an old, fat, long-haired guy. Listen, I got a bunch of stories about local professional wrestling that I did.
Yeah.
Well, then I fought the Mangler once out in Bucks County, PA.
That was in a gymnasium. Your picture from Billions, you look like Jay with a dad. You look like your brother.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't realize that.
Yeah.
You look good, dude.
Yeah.
Look at that.
Yeah, tailored suit. They wouldn't let me have. Although, as this particular picture looks like I'm wearing Paula Poundstone shoulder pads.
Are you going to lay on a stool?
Also, I believe it looks like I'm wearing like some sort of a cool black necklace, but I think that's just my fat neck roll.
No.
Yeah. Yep.
I'm like trying to
look at it. I
think
you're trying to go, no. You're like, no. Yeah.
But I also have bad eyesight. We've known that from when I try to read.
Well, take my word for it. It's not a string. It's not a puka shell necklace. It's my stupid fat neck roll.
Hey, stop it. You look good enough to photo shoot.
No. No.
I
like your picture down there. This is our Google images here. Anyway, that idea of agreeing to be in a picture like that, like I'm posing with my stupid fucking, that's great. Me posing with my stupid fucking,
You look like...
With my sledgehammer and all that shit. And this, yeah, these are all things...
You look like
younger...
Amazing Jonathan.
Yeah, I do. Definitely a magician. They caption contested that on Ron and Fez.
That's great.
One day, and it was... It's on YouTube.
I didn't realize you
actually find that on YouTube, the clip. It's like 36 minutes of me just being shit on for that picture.
Can
it's
I
great.
Tell you this right now? You usually wear, you know, jerseys and T-shirts and stuff, but mm-hmm. see a little, I didn't know you had such a little sexy patch of chest hair.
Oh, my chest beef?
Dude.
A little tiny
what
bit.
A great chest beef.
Me and my dad got the same chest beef. It's a little diamond.
Yeah?
It's right in the middle, yeah.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah, yeah.
At the Bonfire.
Real white trash, yeah, out of the gates.
Oh, I got white trash stomach, body hair. At the Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. We're going to put the clip up of Ron and Fez of Jay's headshot.
I'm not very hairy, though.
I'm not very hairy either, but mine's my chest and then just my stomach.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's not cool looking.
How about nips?
Yeah. It goes across my chest and then like, stragglers.
Your hair looks like Brock Lesnar tattoos.
Yeah, it looks like a sword. Like I have a sword.
Your belly button looks like a whistling mouth with a goatee around it. All I want to do now is draw a dad's face on your torso and make it whistling, whistling dad.
But you say getting talked into bad headshots. That's part of the or bad promotion things is all
just
part
being
of it.
A willing to even. Feel silly like that.
Five years from now, I'm doing a special where I'm like, watch these voices. Set this fire.
I'd love to make one, like an over-the-top one like that. I'd love to make an over-the-top one like
Louis
that.
Louis did a mock one like that.
Yeah, of course.
Which was funny.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's like, now cut to the bright
golden microphone. Yeah. Which was perfect. I like that parody of it. But yeah, we all get talked into it.
But I feel like George Lopez is a little older than that. But it brings me to my point. I said this to you right outside when we met before the show. And it's funny. I pointed it out because I saw it 2 seconds earlier. And then me and you just happened to see it happening again. People are shameless. And in the world of social media we're in,
yeah,
everyone takes pictures constantly. But they pose for them like they're fucking models. It's the weirdest. And when you catch eyes with them.
Yeah.
They don't go weird.
Mm-hmm.
They don't go weird at all. Like, they completely just stay in the pocket with it. Like, isn't that a mind blow to you? I know Christine's going rapid fire on the screen, and we're losing Dan.
Yeah, it's mind blowing to me that people are being inconvenienced.
It's not even the inconvenience that I'm blown away by.
I'm blown away by the inconvenience because there's a waterfall. You guys know what it is in between 48th and 49th, and people like stop to take pictures. But there's been several businessmen like stopping and waiting because this girl's like stretched out, like, "Dad, look, I'm a star."
I mean, literally.
And that's great when you look at people's pictures online. You just know that off camera, there's just like five people in New York like this bitch. What are you doing?
The first one I saw today was the girl had both arms behind her on the railing of the little water bridge there,
mm-hmm.
and one foot up.
Okay.
On, like, you know,
it's a hell of a pose.
And head thrown back, mouth open.
Ah!
Like, can you believe? And then, like,
what a
when I had to walk by, she had to, like, she stopped with, like, an air of, like, come on. And then she just did it anyway and was like, just take the picture either way. And it's like, what? Why are you so over-posing? I've seen it on my street 1,000 times, but like people are so happy to like...
Well, that's always my favorite.
Like a real hardcore pose. When you lock eyes... I'm sorry, but when you lock eyes... Like if I was doing a thing for pure funny, we'll say, right? It's like, dude, act like you're peeing or something into that planter. That'd be funny. And I've got my back turned and I got my arms, shoulders in like I'm holding my dick or whatever. As soon as somebody walks by that I don't know and looks in the direction at all, I'm like, I'd be telling you taking the picture, like, wait. Like, let them go by. Like, let's be normal human beings.
Yeah, have a reaction to people.
Let's not commit. When you look at these people, they're still, like, in their fucking, like, teen Vogue pose.
But I think that's what...
What's happening?
That's what social media is doing, is it's all about... It's not about the people that are actually around you. It's about the people that follow you online and, like, what they see. And that's not really the reality. Like, there's people being like, this person's a fucking idiot taking the picture. And I would feel mortified if I always think about this with hot girls on Instagram. I think about, like, who's taking these pictures? My girlfriend and I talk about it all the time. It's like, and it's Instagram, like, these girls' boyfriends. And they're like, baby, hold it. Go. And they're like, I'm in the ocean. And he's like, you look great. You look so awesome, Amber. You look so awesome. I love you. I'm so glad we're in Mexico together. You're everything to me. You're everything. And she's like, shut up.
She's like,
shut the fuck up. Did you get it?
Take the picture fast while I splash water so you see the droplets.
Ah.
I feel like there's... There's a comic in Philly, Shane Gillis, super funny dude who's open for me, and he showed me this girl, Sierra Sky, if you look her up on Instagram, but she's in like...
Is that a porn star?
It might be.
I think it is.
Sierra, let me see what
if it's not, her name should be.
It's Summer Sky? It's definitely a porn star name. And this girl's like, no, that's not her. Hold on, let me find her name.
I think it's S-I-E-R-R-A.
Sierra Sky, S-I-E-R-R-A-S-K-Y. She is...
S-K-Y-E-E?
Sure. Probably.
Oh, yeah, there it is.
Yeah! But she has a boyfriend, and it looks like a... it looks like a... like, look at all these pictures. Someone took these.
Yeah.
She's not in pictures with people. It's not a normal thing.
Yeah.
Someone had to be like...
So hang on, I'm going to pull my bottom tits out.
She goes, but then her
boyfriend... All right, now go.
But then her boyfriend, dude, I'm so glad. I wish Shane was on the show so we could talk about this, because he's the one that introduced me to this. But she's in a relationship with this guy who's a male model, but it's clearly like, is this a manufactured relationship?
Like they put up, somebody put them together. It's like a boy band relationship.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. There's like a Lou Pearlman who's like, you two pretty kids are going to put, like, look at all her pictures. But,
see, here's the thing. She's smoking hot.
God, she's hot.
Yeah, I get it. And you follow her on Instagram.
No, I don't. I unfollowed her because she annoyed me.
But you were following her.
Maybe.
Yeah.
I've checked in and checked out with multiple ladies online.
This always goes back to my intrigue with the great Vanilla Dan.
Yeah, look at that. That's Vanilla Dan all dirt.
Absolutely. Dude, she's smoking hot, but all that
call
picture...
Call that Breyer's Vanilla.
That white bikini picture right there that we'll send out, I guess, is... That's maybe one of the hottest pictures of all time.
Yeah.
But that said, having that come across my Instagram is absolutely... Here's the two things... When I get that picture, I get furious. So I'm like, well, that girl is never going to want to fuck me. And two, I'm like, and she's not doing pornography, which would make me be like, oh, well, at least I could see her doing pornography.
Right.
Now I'm so like, so all I do is just hate her. I hate that she exists.
Why? Just because she's hot in a bikini?
It's inconsequential. Her hotness has now completely inconsequential in my life.
I think of her as a girl.
I think her, she's completely expendable in the world.
Wow. You are, that's impressive. You're like a Russian czar.
It sounds almost like, when I'm saying it out loud, it sounds like the manifesto of a guy who murders pretty women.
You go, they are trophies and I have to collect them, but they can't be alive.
The earth needs to be cleansed of their beauty. We don't deserve it.
What's happening up here? Are you guys turning it off? Oh, that's convenient, Christine. Jay's talking about how beautiful she is. All of a sudden, there's a glitch.
Oh, looks like she was so hot, she broke the computer.
Oh, there she is.
The computer's spent.
I think of her as a girl I'll never meet and never talk to. She's super hot, and that's her boyfriend rubbing her butt. This guy.
Go back up.
Go back up to that video. Man. And they have like a vlog.
It's a video?
Yeah, because they have a vlog and he's like, hey, babe, are we going to find her? Can you please find her? Their video vlog?
I feel like they all talk. I feel like the guys always talk to him like, remember how Tommy Lee talked to Pamela Anderson?
Yeah, I love you.
I love you, babe.
Please find it. Babe. It's on YouTube.
Love you, babe. Big love.
Want me to honk this and shake? Her voice
you
is
look
so...
At babe.
Her voice is mousy, so she's like, I know anything.
She has like a perfect body.
Yeah, I think it's plastic surgery. You could tweet it
Brazilian
out.
Brazilian butt lift, maybe?
I don't know.
It's really like an insanely perfect body.
Why do you think it's... She's young.
Yeah.
Well, and blessed.
There's her boyfriend to the right. We got to find the one. Yeah. That's why I say it looks manufactured.
Like, I feel like she should be with a better looking dude than that.
What?
Oh, that's a great looking guy.
Yeah, he's got Ewok eyes.
But he's very like, he has two natural Marilyn Manson eyes.
Yeah.
No, he's great looking, but I mean, it depends if you're, he's definitely a pretty guy.
Yeah. But you see what I mean where it looks manufactured? This looks like an underwear ad. This doesn't look like two people that met. Like, she should be dating some 46-year-old rich Jewish guy. This is it.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow.
I wanna just get a little food, maybe a cold brew. But we just got the Jacksons. I would tell them to come outside, but
wait, go back
I have
stop
to
it
really badly.
And go back to the picture of them.
Dude.
Where's the picture?
We're going to get some cold brew.
I want to take that picture and just, like, for some reason, I don't know why, it would be funny to me if he was making, like, an ooh mouth. Like, ew.
Ew.
Like, he's like, ooh. Someone could probably Photoshop that. Yeah. He's making an ooh mouth.
Put an ooh mouth on him at the Bonfire SXF.
I just want his mouth open a little bit. Just like a oh.
Oh, you want me to go inside to buy it? Okay. Hey, Sierra, you want to get out?
I love that. These
My
guys
forearm is... hurts.
Thank you for giving me this.
Well, thank you for giving you this. Thanks, Shane Gillis. He's the one that told me about it.
You're going to destroy this Instagram thing?
No, I love the couple. I love them together.
I'll play the video.
I'm never going to stop watching these videos.
Oh, my God. Like this guy this guy is going to suck as much as you think he's going.
Oh, yeah. He's going to be like, dude, trust me. We watched some in the green room in D.C. at the draft.
By the way.
Yeah.
A guy like this, though, here's when you know you've been in show business too long and you've gone the wrong way, is when you come back and you go, because I actually met that girl's boyfriend. He's actually a pretty cool guy.
No.
Like, that's when you know you fucked up.
Yeah.
No, I know, but that was actually a really great Schumer joke she had at one point, or a story she told about going to a basketball game, like sitting front row with a guy she was on a date with, I guess.
Yeah.
And the guy met, he's like, when he went to get snacks, he was like, hey, I guess I met Kate Upton on the way to the thing. He's like, she's actually really cool. Or she's actually really funny. Or something
yeah,
like that.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
She's like, oh, fuck you, which is a great joke. And I'm like, same thing. And as soon as you go, this guy goes, this guy's actually pretty cool. Like, you're like, oh, no, something's wrong with me now.
Yeah,
I blew it.
Now I'm trying to say nice things just to say nice things, because this guy's been completely different. He's differently wired than 98 percentile of us. It's just an inherent confidence because he has wolf eyes.
I'm going inside to get him. And, yeah, we'll show him. He just got a new place, so... let's check it out.
Let go.
Just ripped jeans. He's like, there's my truck. Hey, baby.
Put your sweater on. It's cold, babe.
That was every guy I went to University of Arizona with that was just getting laid consistently.
Let me give him a call.
So when I went to Arizona, there was a bunch of like rich kids from like San Diego and Long Island, and they all had that kind of confidence where they're like, hey, what's going on, dude? Dude, you want to go do some blow? I got a fucking 9.5 up in my bedroom, and I'm ready to rock. And I go, I don't have any money, and I live with Amir. They're like, you're like Amir's roommate, right? Is that a Cobra Kai shirt? Cool.
Cool.
He goes, I've got rips in my jeans that aren't intentional. All right. Anyways, later, dude.
Yeah, these guys.
The guy FaceTimes his friend when he goes to his apartment. I've watched this video. I watched it with Shane.
Really?
Shout out to Shane M. Gillis.
And he just like...
Yeah.
You just hate the guy the whole way through?
Oh, dude, it gets so much worse. You have no
nothing,
idea.
No redeeming quality, huh?
And no, there's no redeeming qualities.
One way he's like, he goes, oh, man, I'm so tired. Probably from lugging around this big old dong.
Yeah, he goes, oh, hey, Dad. No, I love you, too. Whoa, more money in my account? Okay. Hello.
I'm so happy you and Mom are still together.
Hello, Comedy Central. Oh, you just greenlit a show I worked on for 2 years? Ah, I didn't even write it.
Dude,
it's
Dave, whatchamacallit, but dude, here's the thing.
Jealousy. You're looking at this
I do thing. Wonder, though.
But he's a knob. Keep playing the video.
He's absolutely a knob, but here's my thing. And by the way, if I had a choice,
real quick,
right now, if you're like you could change everything and look like that guy, I just would. But
you just would
in a heartbeat.
Yeah, I love that you change halfway through the sentence. You're just giving your card. You go, one of the greatest senses of humor working today, and like all this great stuff. You're like, look like surfer model guy. Yeah, there you go.
Oh, absolutely. However, that said, I'm not convinced, and it's a bit the older I get, is that that's not a golden ticket, though.
No.
It feels like it. In a certain ways, it is. In the one realm of he's gotten pussy, super hot pussy, super easy his whole life.
Yes.
Aside from that, it doesn't really fix a whole bunch of much else.
I feel like it's when
being
you see
a super
really,
hot guy.
I feel seeing really beautiful people is like when you see like a classic car kept in mint condition on the street, and you're like, oh, fucking cool, man. Look at that, like, old GTO. And then you realize it takes hours and hours of work to maintain and, like, keep up. And you're like, oh, that'd be fucking miserable to own that thing.
I mean, how about the amount of good-looking you would have to be as a dude. And lucky that you're kind of good-looking is exactly what the girl's looking for. And there's girls in power. Like, the odds of a guy being able to fuck his way to the top is impossible, almost.
Do you think it's impossible?
you're a gay man, it's like you don't really. I mean,
you're scummy.
For,
you start being
for
scummy.
A woman can get you. It can be a golden ticket. It can get you a rich husband. It can get you right. all of that fun stuff. But as a guy, it's like it's a very girlish quality to be so beautiful. It's
well, weird. As a guy though, no, you can be a good enough looking guy and get a.
Can you find
a
down?
You can get. Here's the thing. You down, can get a gross.
Real quick, old can you look
woman.
Up down and out? Down and out hot guys, like the ones that didn't make it.
Down and out hot guys?
Yeah, like, you know the one that...
Hot homeless guys.
Hot homeless guys. And like, remember the guy that got arrested and he was like beautiful, like, yeah, and yeah, everyone yeah. was like, his that like great looking black dude.
Yeah, yeah.
And everyone's like, oh, that. He's so hot. So you're right. It's not a golden ticket because the hot that you would have to get to put yourself up there is so astronomical.
It's astronomical.
In the right place.
It's actually in the right
Whoa,
place.
Look at this story.
It's, listen, it's astronomical in the right place, but also... You have to, like, find, like, because here's the thing. You may have, like, a very attractive girl who's the boss.
Yeah.
And you're trying to fuck your way into the boss's good graces. But she just happens to be into, like, biker yeah. dudes. Like, good-looking biker dudes.
Or she's actually into, like, funny, nebbish Jewish guys.
No, here's, by the
There's,
way.
Like, there are women who are, like, but
it's the argument, though, of, like, good-looking and a dude goes yeah. in so, it's so all over the place. Do you know what I'm saying? Where
yeah.
you could be like a rugged, good-looking, like bikery dude, or you could be a soft, kind of pretty, like girly.
I think beautiful dude. In general. If you wind up on the street, Christina's brought up an article about Kendall Jenner and Gigi Hadid.
Hadid
helped a hot homeless guy become a model. That my point is this: if you're a hot homeless dude, you're a piece of shit. Like you've burned every bridge because even with those doe eyes, you can't be like, oh yeah. yeah, he's like a young guy.
I mean, come on,
this what's
guy
his can, story?
This guy could shack up with a new moderately fat girl every night. If
oh, you,
wanted you
mean
to.
Mini Marlon Brando? Look at that one picture. Wait, is there the story about him? Can you find the story like about why he was homeless?
I will look.
He goes, they were doing blow in a bathroom where he was sucking a dude off through a glory yeah. hole for $5.
He goes, I just had to eat an alley cat. They go, your abs look fucking sick. And he's all, okay, well, I'm hoping the blood disease doesn't sit in. Have you ever had scabies in your dick?
His hair is so dope. Which, whose? That guy over there petting the rat.
yeah. Oh, my God. Look at that guy that just dumpster dived. What a fucking ill photo shoot.
You see that guy squatting down there taking his shit off the tracks?
Was,
is that guy, like, the hottest, or am I nuts?
Oh, my God. Look at his fucking quads. He's, like, locked down, completely shitting. He goes, I'm the 17th president of the United States. He's just mentally
ill. See that guy ripping heat right there in the corner of that Starbucks and CVS?
I am a god, and I will eat your face. We need to fucking foot down. You found out what happened?
It's really, like, you know, homeless is a loose term. It's a guy
yeah.
that grew up in Wisconsin and moved to California, and he, like, crashes on his friend's couch and skateboards.
I could have already said that's what his story was.
Fuck all of this.
He was, I mean, hang on. He's homeless, and then parentheses, it says, shrugs bangs at his face. So I'm homeless or whatever.
Yeah, parents, you know, parents, they just don't understand.
He also said Kendall and Gigi were super cool.
I know. What an idiot. They were super cool. I met them and
he goes,
they were like.
They're very warm ladies on the inside and out.
Yeah.
God.
He goes, body's 98.6 degrees. Shouts out to Nick Lachey. yeah, did you find any other down and out homeless guys?
Why does Drew Lachey never get the show?
Play that. Can you play that video? What's that?
Why does Drew Lachey never get the show?
He took his money and he invested it wisely and he's having a good life. You leave Drew Lachey out of this. He didn't ask for no goddamn public life. He just wanted to dance and sing. Dude, if I ever FaceTime you walking up to your house, fight me.
Oh, please.
Because this guy FaceTimes his friend to go
yeah,
see his
bro,
apartment.
Yeah, bro, guess he's outside.
Watch. Hit it.
He's like, what's your car?
Dude.
We're here.
What's good, kid?
Hey. I'm here. Come get the door. Where's he at?
I'd be like,
there
are you
is.
Fucking... Are you an idiot? I buzzed you. Why are you FaceTiming
oh,
me?
Oh, dude. Ah. Guy, the guys get too excited when they see each
yeah.
other.
Oh,
dude.
Bro, send it.
Dude.
And you're fucking like,
Oh, here it comes. Oh, here's the express train right to Friendship Time. Friendship Town, not time. Hit play. This guy, it's going to get worse.
Fuck it.
God. Oh, look at the feng shui. Oh, you dig? This thing's off the chain. Is this the red?
Yeah, it says red on it.
You know.
Oh, it's hilarious. They all know fucking cameras. That's where they're all of a sudden they're technology wizard with the cameras. He goes, is this got a 2.5 focus in?
Oh, bro, is this a fucking 1080p fucking X-Red? You dog, dude. They don't come out with this in fucking Lola. You know someone in some tech.
Dude, before we take our first break,
Can we just fucking roll this into the live show?
I just want to give you a taste
I'm
of the
I'm so fun. Mad I brought this up during this show because I was going
to
keep going.
I'm going to just make you, I just want you to enjoy this thing. It was a clip I saw on Tosh.0. Have you seen the thing of the guy saying he's going to ride the snowmobile over somebody? He goes, I'm still going to send it. Have you seen this? Oh, please just play. We'll preview play this, and maybe we'll come back to it. Dude, this is going to make you so happy.
Also, he's got a guitar on the couch. You know who else had a guitar?
That's the friend he's going to.
That's the friend, the hot guy. We're talking back to the video that we're watching, but hot guys.
Oh, man, I was just strumming when you guys pulled up.
You know who else had a guitar on his couch? Chris Cornell. Maybe he was about to choke jerk.
Hello. Oh, dude, this is one of the funniest.
I'm so sorry. That was so gross. Bless you.
This is one of the funniest. It's like lines, the way a guy said ever in my life. Listen to this, and we'll take a break.
I don't know, I just woke up from a little nap. It's a little dark, but you guys silly? I'm still going to send it.
You guys silly? I'm still going to send it.
Dude, he just eats shit. He just eats shit on a snowmobile.
Oh!
Are you silly? I'm still going to send it.
Oh. He's all,
that's what he means. Hey, that's what he means by sending it.
Hey, I'm good.
You guys silly? I'm still gonna send it.
I'm still gonna send it.
That guy makes me so happy.
But that guy should have the other guy's looks. He should have.
This guy's not fucking any super hot chick.
Oh man, the chicks. Imagine if he woke up in the bed of what other guy's fucking, and the hot guy woke up in the bed of what he's fucking.
Hey, vice versa.
Oh, vice versa. A Judge Reinhold classic.
Can you go to the Larry and Tyser quotes? This is a great thing.
New jump here. Just gonna send it.
That's like his thing.
Gonna hit her about 3/4 to full throttle. Come down that hill pretty fast. Hit that water, just gonna hold her wide. Gonna be a good day.
Dude, good for this guy. He's just videotaping himself.
I think I can send that on the old Super Twin, no problem.
His hair's magical.
Yeah.
I mean, this guy is fan. This is not a long time ago.
I just woke up from a little nap. It's a little dark, but you guys silly? I'm still gonna send it.
Yeah, that's his catchphrase.
Yeah, I'm gonna send it.
This dude can just take an ass whooping. What's his name?
He calls it sending it. Larry and Tyser.
Yeah.
Larry and Tyser. Oh, look at Larry with the glasses off.
DT still runs, so round two. Are you sure it
still runs? Dude, this guy's badass.
He really is. I wonder if it translates to like him just getting like if he just like,
oh god damn, he could take a fucking shot.
Another day, another beer.
Shit, you hear me? Oh, she'll fire up. Just need some gas down the cylinder.
He's wearing all denim.
Yeah. Oh yeah. She's. I wonder if it's a character.
The world needs more dudes like this. There is not a character at all.
Dude, I love he's got gas in a fucking Poland Spring bottle.
If Red Dawn ever happens, you better look. You better find Larry and Tyser.
Dude, yeah, Larry and Tyser's going to be the one with all the cans of fucking Chef Boyardee ravioli in his bomb shelter.
Let's take our first break. When we come back from the break,
more.
Sure,
hot.
It's only been 5 minutes for you. But God knows what's happened since then.
Can we do more Hawkeye video blog?
Oh, I'll find all kinds of hot. I just want to watch male models talking. Remember, we were supposed to even do that before with the
porn stars.
Porn stars. Yeah, we never got to them enough.
That's the best part about the lost tapes. It just keeps coming up and
keep going. Don't even matter. All right, everybody, we'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
I'll tell you what. I mean, they, you know, were very corny when they came out, but looking back, we all wish we knew choreographed dance moves now.
Oh, my God, those moves, dude.
Those moves! Those sweet, sweet moves! I, of course, in the boy band war, always picked NSYNC because it begot JT. He's the Jordan of boy bands.
It is funny watching
JC Chassé is Pippin.
Oh, I watched.
Don't ever forget it.
I watched a little the other night of NKOTBSB.
Oh!
On. It was on like the H High Def channel or whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, no, the Music Live channel. MTV's got a live channel now.
Finally? Oh, they're back to being MTV?
Well, no. It was...
Oh, it's like Palladium.
It used to be Palladium.
Okay. So they changed it?
Palladium changed to MTV Live.
Yeah.
But no, it's all still the same thing. It's all live shit.
Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. It's a Lost Tapes. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson. We were watching a...
NKOTBSB is no bullshit.
It also sounds like a narcotics group that you join to get off junk. NKOBTB, you're like...
NKOTBSB?
I had to do that. I had to do 30 days there.
Do they come out and they, at one point of the concert, they act like they're facing off against each other?
Or
gacing off? What do you call it?
One of them doesn't get the memo and just starts losing his shit on all the Backstreet Boys. They're like,
what are you doing? We're 48.
Another one of them doesn't realize there's an audience there and just starts heavily making out with everybody. Yeah,
before the break, we were watching gorgeous couple Sierra Sky and what's her boyfriend's name? Roman Palumbo?
Joey Fatone, huh?
He's near a buddy of yours?
I know him, but he also, in this video particularly, we are rocking similar hair.
I don't think that's
a lot of comparisons to me and Joey Fatone. First of all, his last name, broken up, spells fat one, which always bothered me. Of course it's the one I look like the most.
Yeah, you want to be...
I never look like Slim Thug
or like Troy Big Dick. You know, look at break that name up.
Willie McHugehammer. That's never who
Willie
I look like.
Willie McHugehammer sounds like a fucking guy from a fairy tale from the 1800s.
The story of Willie McHugehammer.
You gotta... there's gotta be a certain kind of muscle in you that goes, I'm gonna commit to dancing good. Because it does not feel cool doing
that. Wow, you and Fatone do have very similar hair.
Yeah, we got a whole thing going.
Yeah, that dancing thing, it's like, I think there's like a certain amount of confidence, and then you dive into the abyss. You're like, I'm going to get really good at this.
Yeah, you have to like, you got to do it with like an angry, like like what I was doing during the break. It was like,
gotta by me. Left, right, over.
Because
stick it, one, two.
But that's modern dancing, because like back in the 30s and 40s, they always did like smiley, like falling into a dance move. They're like, I'm out in the rain. I'm going around dancing, treat back black people like they're animals.
But you
are racist bigots.
But you have to approach dancing like it's
But now it's like a fight.
Like aggression, yeah. That's what I'm saying in this. It's like this aggression they have to be doing. Because they have to do it, no pun intended, in sync.
Ha ha! Yeah, like this.
Who's this? Gene Autry?
Fred Astaire.
Fred Astaire he looks all happy. See?
No, wait a second. Put hardcore music to this, though.
Oh, yeah.
Put this song to that.
Oh, let's have Fred Astaire dancing to In Sync.
Get rid of this big band bullshit.
Cut the volume on him.
And crank up some Bye Bye Bye. Or it's gonna be me.
Let's see if we can do this.
Now nothing.
Are we gonna do a match?
Say what, it looks just as weird if he's dancing to nothing as you're making it happen now. Now it looks like a slave we're making do something.
Or he looks like a drunk lunatic. Where you're like, all right, I got it.
Oh, crazy Gene's outside.
Gene, what do you do? Look at this. This is my neighbor. Look what he does in the parking lot.
Oh, old nutty Fred from across the street. Does it hold up? There was always a flair of like gay risk to the whole thing, wasn't there?
What,
even back then, look,
old dancing.
Yeah, watch him go back. Go back a little bit on Fred Astaire. Watch like it's a very limpy, flippy wrist thing going on.
I see what you mean.
Yeah, see what I'm saying? Hey, boys, look at it. Yeah, now we're kicking.
Dancing. Oh, this is perfect.
That is something I want to ask you. Get it, Freddy?
Yeah. Go for it. Oh, he's fucking fagging out hard.
Oh, my God. We were just doing blow in the bathroom, and we did not know you guys were going to be dancing out here.
Spin, bitch. Spin.
Fred is gacked out of his mind. We were just butt-fucking, and he's...
Fred Astaire is tooted, and he is ready to fucking spin.
I might as well change his name to Hoover, because he just took down an 8-ball like it was his job.
Jack Nicholson's in the audience. Got him all ripped up.
He goes, hey, I just put him on a bunch of blow. Watch him go. I hope his heart doesn't blow up.
By the way, go back to what Fred Astaire is doing. You could learn this in a heartbeat.
No, you can't.
Sure you can.
No, you can't.
I could do everything he's doing right
Dude,
now.
You also said you could do the New Edition dance, and you never learned it.
I never learned it, but I can, I'm capable of all the moves.
No, then you came in and were like, that would have been too hard.
No, it would have been too hard to memorize it. Move by move, I'm good on every one of those things.
Who is this?
You start throwing some kid and play in the mix where I have to do out, like, where I have to jump over my own leg or something. I cannot do that. Everything Fred Astaire just did, I could do right now watching it in real time with him.
No, you couldn't. Go, please bring up that Fred Astaire. There's no way you could do that.
Go back to it. Go back to the beginning.
You guys silly? I'm still going to send it.
That's true. Don't be silly. I'm going to send that.
Are you guys crazy? Of course I can do it in front of Stare Nose. I'm still going to send it.
How do you have no confidence in yourself that you can't do this? He's doing nothing. Oh, yeah, Dan.
Well, it's a lot of time.
I'm sorry. Your fucking body must not move or something.
Do that.
Are you a quadriplegic, I'm unaware?
All right, let's
do
see
what,
it.
Do this?
No, stand up and do it. Stand up
what?
And do it. Let's see if you can move with that gracefulness. He's moving gracefully.
That's your big example? He's moving gracefully?
Jay's got rhythm.
He does. I'm not saying he doesn't have rhythm, but I'm saying I don't think you could dance like Fred Astaire.
This looks like a person playing with a baby.
It does.
But this video better be out there in the world. Let me watch how horrible this dancing is. Fuck Fred Astaire. No one else had the balls to say it all these years
God damn
before
it,
me.
I know you've always been a Gene Kelly guy, but I need you to pump the brakes.
There you go. Look, I don't technically know how to tap dance.
Tapping is harder than it looks.
Really, I think it's just dancing with fucking bottle caps on your shoes.
Yeah.
What do I know?
I like always when you bring up something about the performing arts, there's something in Christine that sometimes gets honest where she's like, well, it's a lot harder than it seems, but Jay does have rhythm, but it's a lot harder than it seems.
Christine doesn't believe in my dancing abilities at all. I'm saying it doesn't matter.
I think you can dance. I don't think you can Fred Astaire dance.
Come on. Not listen.
Do it.
I can't climb up, run up a wall and flip, but that's not what he's doing here. This is an old Fred Astaire.
I can do what Jack Nicholson's
doing.
I'm pretty good at that right there.
I really want Jay to take tap now.
Dude, what if you just busted out a tap routine? If you secretly took lessons and didn't tell us, and then you did some soft shoe at the next live.
Fat tap? I call it FAP, but unfortunately that already means jerking off.
Yeah. I go.
Just gonna send it!
guys, I'm still gonna send that.
I'm still gonna send that.
You guys silly? I'm still gonna send it.
You can just play it back to back 7 times, and I'll be okay with it.
I do love
it. You guys silly? I'm still gonna send it.
Let's go back to the hot. We're getting away from the hot person blog.
That guy makes me so happy, though.
I'm still gonna send that.
Are you silly? I'm still gonna send it. Well, whatever. Change the subject if you want, Dan. Just know that I was prepared to get up and do a complete Fred Astaire dance. But you're
okay.
Right. But you're right. We got to get back to this thing.
No, we don't. Let's bring that up.
It's too late. We've already switched screens.
We've already switched the screens,
and now we're on to the blog.
You always
thing.
Get out of dancing.
No. All right, little taste. Hang on, look at my wrist.
You know, it's funny because you just like walk around like you're drunk. And you're like,
yeah. Oh, hey, oh, my little gimpy wrist. Oh, hey, there's not enough D in this room.
And everyone can do Fred Astaire dancing if you just sit in a chair like this and you just go.
That's
right.
I mean, how great is Corey Feldman's dancing if he's just doing what would be considered Michael Jackson's dancing? Right?
Actually, this syncs up kind of great.
Is Corey Feldman a fantastic dancer?
That's the other video I had up is an old Fosse dance routine. They synced up to Walk It Out, and then actually it's basically the single ladies dance from Beyonce's video.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm watching this, and it's syncing up with Michael Jackson.
Now, here's the thing. Can I do this? All, Dan? Yes. The answer is yes, I could. But it might not sound like good tapping.
Okay.
But these movements?
You can't do that.
I can't jump over a cane? How fat do you think I am?
Dude.
It's a cane, Dan. It's laying flat on the ground.
There's no way you could do any of this.
Spin around and step on a cane? Oh, cane step. Oh, you're right. No, the only thing I can't do here is probably fit into a tuxedo that has tails. That's what I probably can't do.
I think they have it. You could do that kick up and grab that cane like that?
I believe I could do all those cane moves.
I doubt that.
Oh,
you could
Dan,
do
you don't even know. My staff work is dope.
Can you? Yeah. I go, by the way, I doubted Big J, and then I saw him work a cane, and I apologize.
Oh, my staff work? Anybody got an umbrella? I'll do that. This whole thing he's doing.
No, you won't.
Oh, dude.
I am a doubter. I'm a Big J denier.
You are a doubting Daniel.
I'm a doubting Daniel. All right, now back to the hot person right, vlog.
I know. We want to get to the hot people dancing. I'm just letting you guys know I was 2 seconds away from really busting out a whole routine. In fact, I'm back to thinking I can climb up and flip off the wall.
Are you back? Are you back to thinking you can do a kip-up?
I never said I could do a kip-up. I'm mentally not prepared for it. 2 weeks of therapy, I do a kick-up. It's a kip-up. It's got nothing to do with the physical act of it.
It's all mental.
It's all mental.
You're right. You're absolutely right.
It's all mental. Everyone in this room, with the exception of White Lou, is able to do a kip-up if they believe in themselves.
I hope that inspires Witski to go home and just learn it, and like with Stu just standing there going, kip-up! Kip-up! And then just keep working, and then finally he comes in and he goes, hey, Jay, can I talk to you real quick around the corner? All right, hold my hat. He just lays down. Kip-up!
Oh, you know it's really going to be fucked up when we find out that was Stu the whole time. It wasn't even you.
Like the doink and dink,
yeah.
And I remember that.
You sent him in to take your place.
I don't want to do a kip up. I'd rather masturbate and hang myself.
Right?
Okay.
Have you tried it yet?
Choke jerk?
No, I can't do it alone. You know that's dangerous.
That's true. But you have a twin brother who will know if something bad's happening. He'll come running.
No, yeah, he'll spot me, but we just got to coordinate our times.
I didn't mean
do you guys? Do you guys think after you do a successful choke jerk, you'll do like a home run handshake? Like, picks him up. He goes,
flip, flip, oh, easy breezy. Oh, you remember the end of 21 Jump Street's credits? They had Peter DeLuise and Johnny Depp did a fucking...
He goes, all right, I got to go wipe down.
Do you remember that?
Yeah.
At the 21 Jump Street opening credits, Johnny Depp and Dom DeLuise do like a...
we should have a bonfire handshake. Huh? Yeah, over there.
I'll tell you what. A black guy and a white guy, actually, a kid, Mike Brown, who opened for me in Maryland.
Yeah.
This last weekend.
Baltimore.
When he got off stage, him and his best friend, who's a comedian also, I don't remember his name, but they had a whole handshake routine.
I think we bring that back. I think it unites people.
You don't have to bring it back. It's happening, buddy.
Good.
Derek Gaines has a different handshake, an involved 2-minute routine.
Yeah.
With almost everybody he knows.
There's videos of that coming up of like teachers with kids having different handshakes. Like I've seen that on like World Star, I think it was on.
It's the shittiest, dumbest thing I've ever heard of.
Well, this is where we differ again.
Let's not jump subjects yet.
Okay.
Because internal handshakes, inside group handshakes, mean the world to me. But I don't want that.
Okay.
Oh, he's got personalized with every one of his students. His teacher. All right. God damn it. We have to look at it.
It's at the Bonfire SXM to see the video. He's doing it. They look like third or fourth graders walking through. By the way, this is an incredible memory for him to remember all this. I like the kid that just does the salute.
One kid just does the salute. Looks like a well choreographed fight.
Yeah. Like, what's the dance fighting?
I wish all teachers cared this much.
About handshakes?
Just about their students.
You know
what would
be even better? What if he was just a terrible teacher?
Like that's what I was going to say. He goes, now, what do you teach? He goes, oh, man, I don't know. What's the science say? Science? I don't know.
Mr. Dawkins, I'm here with the school board, and it seems that you have not got any of the syllabus through. However, you do have 32 individual handshakes. Look at this kid. Just shoots him. You're like, oh my god! Oh my god!
Wow.
Adorable.
Yeah.
He teaches none of that was adorable. He teaches he teaches Jesus science because he's black and everything.
Gotta go pray.
They just go. No, they just say they go. Wait a second. How does a tadpole turn into a frog? That ain't nothing but Jesus right there.
I'll never forget. Dude,
Jesus won it.
I saw it at my buddy's funeral.
How do trees grow? Jesus.
At my buddy's funeral, I saw one of my friends that, it's weird, Sal's on the TV over there, and you're like, hey, Sal. But one of my buddies in middle school was like, how do mosses fuck? He just asked that in science class, and we were learning about my friend David.
Mosses?
Yeah, we were learning about moss, and he goes, how do mosses fuck? And you go, oh, boy, well, that's going to be in school suspension for you.
Oh, that's my thought was much more. I was like, I don't think mosses fuck.
That was the funniest thing. And it's plural. I think it's just moss in general.
Yeah, how does moss fuck? And
it's wrong anyway.
But David was hilarious because I think I've told this before one day.
Sorry, time, how's Moss make love?
He had a shaved head. He just one day just took Carmex and just started fucking Carmexing his head up so it was all shiny in science class because he hated our science teacher, Mr. Coons. That's his name. Little white guy with a mustache.
Wow. Yeah, you definitely had to clarify that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's a white guy. Old white guy. Mr. Coons.
Jim Spearchucker. Irish. Irish-American.
Oddly enough, Scottish. Yes, I know my name is Mark. My name is Randall Negro. It's a great Scottish name. Remember it. Don't think it's racial. There's a lot of racial tension.
That's such a great to have crazy racist black names.
Yes, my name is Mr. Blackface.
Oh, shit. That's fucking Mr. Coons.
These two fucking smiling idiots just keep... I want to go back to it.
You want to watch him make love?
Yeah, I do. Fuck yeah. You don't?
Of course. It's the only way I'd respect this. Remember I told you that yesterday? I mean, I told you that before the break.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I forgot. Only minutes ago.
Only seconds ago. Duh, stupid. Remember I told you that yesterday? No. I said this is why I hate the girl.
We're talking about
Sierra. I can't
sleep
with her and I can't see her naked.
We're talking about Instagram model Sierra Sky, who comedian Shane Gillis out of Philadelphia put me onto in a green room. And I started watching these video blogs. And it is a wormhole.
Yeah, I started liking Miley Cyrus as soon as she started showing me like her butthole and stuff because I'm like, oh, well, great. There it is. I liked her when she was younger because she would entertain my daughter.
Yeah.
And I was like, I could appreciate her then. Then it gets to a point when she's not entertaining my daughter anymore and then I got to put her in that world like... Am I going to see her naked?
Purgatory.
Or am I going to see her naked or do I get to experience her myself?
I call that the Alyssa Milano model.
Yeah,
it's like at first entertain me on the show Who's the Boss, then
yes,
entertain me by being nude and sexualized.
And she did it.
And she did it.
She did it to a small, a lower level than I would like.
Yeah, but
in the world of
Vanilla,
sex tapes, now,
Vanilla Dan, that was great.
I'd say Vanilla Dan would almost think it was too harsh. You want to get back to the?
Come on, dude. You're not that. I'm not that vanilla.
I think there's almost some. I think there's almost a little bush in one of those scenes. You sure? You okay?
I'm Vanilla Bean Dan.
You okay, Vanilla Bean?
I'm Vanilla Bean.
You are a VB?
VB. VBD.
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 My mom thinks I'm special. No.
Who is saying that he does look like one of the Mirror Image kids?
Someone. Everyone.
Oh, Black Lou said that yesterday. He goes, he looks like one of the grown-up Mirror Image kids.
And she looks like, she looks like Piper Perabo.
Oh, but just, oh, yeah, she does. Wait till she starts talking because it kills the boner. She's like, hi, Mimi.
By the way, Roman's eyebrow game, not quite as good as mine.
Oh!
I'm just going to put that out there.
Oh, your eyebrow game is weak!
Yo, that shit ain't toy!
Christine, go to the part where he's already FaceTime his friend as he's walking up, which is probably one of the most obnoxious things I've ever seen in my life. If anyone ever FaceTimes me as they're trying to come over, I hate people that publicly FaceTime.
I'm outside, bro. Can you let me in? He goes, don't be silly. I'm still going to send that.
I'm outside. I'm still going to send that.
I'm outside, but I'm still going to send that.
I'm going to start saying that with texts.
But I think it's, this might be texts. Our age. This is where our age, where you're leaning more towards me than you are to, like, Isabella or someone like her age because... I don't think Isabella would, my daughter would find it bizarre to FaceTime somebody out front of their house.
Is it weird?
I wouldn't do it.
You wouldn't do it.
But it's okay.
Why?
But like, I would just text my friend that I'm
outside.
Because
you're white? Don't be racist, Isabella.
She's half Colombian. Come on.
Come on. She is half Colombian. That's right.
She's
you're
like,
not
stupid,
white.
I'm outside, stupid.
Yeah. Open the thing.
Oh, open the mira. I'm outside.
I can't keep all this cocaine in my bajo any longer.
But you wouldn't do that just because it's...
I would phone call. If they didn't answer the door, I would call them on the phone, but I wouldn't FaceTime.
That's what a rational person does, Isabella.
So you're saying these are assholes on TV.
Yeah, all right. Fair enough. Let's see it. Play, Christine.
Dude.
What's good, kid?
By the guy, the guy couldn't be better.
First off, his ex...
Broski!
Yeah, his X Games voices.
Look who it is!
They're definitely not somewhere where you need to be wearing a knit winter cap.
No, because the people that are usually like white trash and like, where did you bring the Ski-Doo or not?
Yeah, yeah, no, this is a guy going like, bro, skiff.
Hey!
Want a longboard to somewhere?
I know, I got a wool hat on. Guess if my pants or shorts. Quick reveal.
Skorts.
It's always shorts. Summer linen.
Oh, me, man, I like the sun. I love pickles.
Dude, I love when you do overexcited guy to see his friend.
Oh, my God, is that the king and savior himself? What's up, Brando?
Oh, shit, if it is, it's the sexiest goddamn couple in all of Redondo.
Oh, my God, when you guys fuck, it's like when water meets the beach. Of course, his dick is the beach and your pussy is water. I'm dumb.
Your pussy is agua.
I legally got tested by the state of California. I am mentally retarded.
When they use a little bit of Spanish, to, yeah. You know how they're Mexican.
Hola, chicas.
Come on now, hermano. Don't flip out of my house. Dude. You know my dad gets home, he's going to beat my ass if we mess up the garage.
I want to fucking shoot a goddamn spear through someone's chest when I hear chicas. It makes me want to like take a fucking harpoon gun and just be like, boom, like right in their chest.
Hey, what's up, chicas?
Fuck you, you garbage.
Hola, hermanos.
Ah, tongue kiss. Cheek kiss.
All right.
Christine's smiling because we're taking her back to her entire growing up through her early
hola,
20s.
Hola, chicas really does bug the fuck out of me. Cause
it would almost make Christine start wiping off her lipstick because she knows it's about to go down.
Oh, this bitch want to go?
Oh, no. I was making more she's going to start beeging people off.
I took it the fight route.
What? Look at it! Oh, look at the feng shui.
That's a word I heard. That's a word I heard once as far as like furniture placement.
Feng shui. Oh, by the way,
hey,
also...
my mom's boyfriend Rob used to beat me with a bell.
And start saying real stuff. You're like, oh. God.
By the way, I never tried. Anyone who's got an electric stovetop, you didn't give a shit when you bought this place.
I don't think he bought it. I think he's renting it.
No, that's what I mean. Yeah, what I'm saying. Either way, you looked at that place, you're like, I don't care, bro. I don't really cook much anyway.
Does it nuke mac and cheese? All right. I'm going to plop out on the couch, Broseph.
All right, play.
Dig! This thing's off the chain. Is this the red?
Yeah, that's the red.
It's just the red.
You know.
It says red right across it.
You fucking dunce.
That was more of an arbitrary question.
That was a question. I was mocking you because the signage is so big. It's like, let the product speak for itself.
Nice signage.
Nice signage, Broseph. All right.
I'll do the surfboard dominates the living room.
Yeah.
We're gonna hit the road in a couple minutes, get the day started. Stay tuned.
We just finished double-teaming this fine piece of woman right here.
She really has no brain cells. I'm pretty sure she ran away from home. I don't know. She doesn't answer full sentences.
But she's putting this out like this is not... She's not doing this as a joke.
No, there's nothing self-aware about this.
Wiggling her butt like that? And by the way, she looks great.
This is like the mission statement we always have a problem with is when people lack complete self-awareness that they don't look like... Because we realize how big of idiots we look like all the time. Yeah. I can barely read publicly. I'm like Floyd Mayweather in this motherfucker when they put something up on that screen. I'm like, and then it went. So we know how dumb we are.
Sleep noom? Sleep numero?
Sleep numero?
This girl's dancing. Very sexy, by the way. But again, it's the situation where it's like you're putting it out in the world of like, look how sexy. That's so foreign to me. Like, look how fucking badass or look how great this is.
Why do you think I'm so uncomfortable with my ex-girlfriend at Bonner?
Because she kept putting out there. She goes, look at handsome Dan. Look how fucking dope I look in my shirt.
Me? No, not me. No. Her.
Her. I'm saying she was doing that.
She was wearing, like, dresses where I'm like, why are you dressing like that? We're going to a fucking dirt-infested comedy show. And she's like,
so what? Are you insecure? Why can't you just let me wear what I want to wear? Because
like, half your tits out. And I'm fucking just eating. I'm eating funnel cakes. I can feel my man tits popping out my t-shirt. And you're like wearing it. You're like, and I'm gonna put some bedazzled around my belly button. You're like, shut the fuck up.
I'm just gonna lap up some rainwater while you guys eat that funnel cake.
Yeah, you're gonna have Wendy's. I gotta go over here and need drainage water. All right, hit play.
Let's see a little booty pop.
We are heading to where?
Beachwood Market.
Beachwood Market.
She barely talks.
Maybe a muffin, some coffee.
That's cool. This guy does all the talking, bro.
He goes, where are we going again? Oh, I don't know.
She's like, I'll decide, babe. It's totally cool. Anywho.
She's like a GPS, but doesn't know directions.
I think it's 300 feet. Walking or driving?
Her voice is so weird because you really, like, you see so many pictures of her and you want her to have, like, kind of a smoky, voluptuous voice. And then she talks and you're like, whoa, God.
What are you smoky? You want to have a Kathleen Turner?
Yeah. Where you going? Boys? What do you want? You want to see one? Oh, I'm going to really Melvin this thing in between my sniz lips.
If you give her that yeah. voice, this changes the video blog completely. Where he goes, hey, what's up? We're going to go out here. Here's my babe. She goes,
oh, my sexy boy. Kathleen Turner voice. If you need me, I'll be down here mowing down my muff. She goes, oh, God, why don't you show me that stick shifter, huh?
He goes, all right, babe, you're getting a little aggro.
That helmet's pretty purple, huh? Must have been a while.
Yeah, I'll stomp on your nuts. That's you wrong right. me.
Don't worry, old Sierra's going to take care of you.
Play.
Old sailor voice Sierra. You know why I was named after you? You know why I was named Sierra? Because my parents said I was born in a storm.
Booty pop, booty pop, booty pop.
Hey, can I booty pop for you, buddy?
Hey, pal. Hey, listen, before you leave, let me booty pop for you real quick. Let me know. My boyfriend's coming by. I want to make sure I'm doing it right. Is this good? Boom, 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 boom. What do you think? What are you thinking? What are you thinking?
Hey, champ. Hey, champ. Watch me move my butt cheeks. Hold on. Ready? There it is. Over there. There it goes.
Yeah. Shake it. Move it. Go, hang on, reverbing.
Slowly reverbing. It's turning into Craig Glazer's daughter.
I'm reverbing. Ghost of the most.
Doctor there.
Doctor there.
I'm booty popping. Doctor
booty,
there.
Booty popping. Booty popping. King of Sting.
Oh, they're driving too fast.
Oh, sped up. Like GTA. Smart.
They're out in Hollywood.
Hollywood.
All right, we just got here.
All right, we just got here. I'm going to rob this store and fucking murder.
Yeah, that's the biggest. Okay.
Time to go bail out and be a real man.
We're fucking here.
He goes, my babe's going to work cash register. I'm going to kill this motherfucker. Here we go. Rock and roll time.
Should we even get into the store? Because we got to stop in like a minute. Should
yeah,
we even
let's get just into a little store? Bit. Let's just taste a little bit.
A little taste of the store? All yeah. right. Hey, here's my boy. You wanted a cheese? Fuck you, old man. Run that cash register.
No, you don't understand. Not again. I cannot have another robbery. Please leave my store. Leave my store.
He fucking
saw
my face.
Shut the fuck up. Shut the fuck up and put the money in the fucking bag.
He fucking saw my face, man. He's gonna die. He's gonna die. Baby, booty pop in the corner. Booty pop in the corner.
Don't look, babe. And he goes, video block. We're back in the car. We're gonna go back to Jacob's.
What'd you do?
Yeah.
Did you fucking blow this guy's face clean off while I was booty popping in the corner?
Baby, you gotta tell me this. If I'm shaking my butt, I need to know if you're spilling blood.
Baby, you know, this is a great market right here. You can buy it's everything. It's like a... It's like a...
hand me my pills out of my purse, lover.
Right, let's see.
That's cool. Right.
See her
oh, yeah,
voice?
Sarah likes these.
Can I get this?
She goes, I like these. Mean may I please have these?
It's such an erection killer.
Can I please have these?
Watch what she says.
I like these. Can I have these?
I'm a cold brew type
these.
Of guy.
We like That's these, Ralph.
Oh, yeah, Sarah likes these.
Can I get this?
Yeah, grab whatever you want, baby girl.
Oh.
He's such a nut. Get the old school. I don't like sweet on mine.
Okay, then should I get three?
Just get two. One for you and Jackson.
Can I please go over there? And I'm very small.
Like, how many is two? He's like, the boobs number, babe.
Okay. How many is two? I don't know how many
it's the boobs, babe. What do we do with the flashcards? The boobs. Remember the boobs?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
So two, okay.
She looks down, she goes like this.
One.
Yeah, with
just the... left, right. Okay, so I can do these. Can I bring both of them in the same... Can I bring both of them at the same time? I go to the bathroom and
it's like when a four-year-old trying to tell you a story.
I go to the bathroom and then I go over there and I don't know where he goes.
Hey, yeah, that's great, kid. Hey, is your mom around? Or... yeah. Let's take our break, and then we'll come right back, and we'll finish up these. I mean, we haven't... There's a whole page of these blogs, by the way. We are sort of... We are a fourth of the way into one.
two minutes into an eight-minute video.
I mean, it's pretty crazy. Well, we'll be right back. To you.
To you. Through time!
It's the mixtapes.
Lost tapes, bro.
That's what I meant. It's the lost tapes, but it's a mix of stuff.
True.
Right here. On the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
You guys silly? I'm still gonna send it.
You know we're gonna send it.
I gotta send it. It's the Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson.
Hootie-hoo.
It's a Lost Tapes episode of the Bonfire, and this marks the first guest of a Lost Tapes episode.
Is it?
Yes. And what a better guest to have than the Puerto Rican rattlesnake, the real-ass dude, Luis J. Gomez.
Luis J.
You don't get microphone.
Luis.
Oh, there's a rattlesnake in here.
Very happy to be back on the Bonfire. This is very nice. You guys have a very nice podcast set up here. Very cool.
It's a serious satellite radio show.
It's a radio show, though.
What's satellite?
Dave does that joke
radio.
Already. catch Lewis up to what we've been talking about. We found out
with satellite radio in every car made in the world now.
Cars.
As a New Yorker, could you explain? Oh, cabs?
He goes,
that's weird.
They're in cabs?
The yellow ones where I try to fight the drivers? catch you up on what we've been talking about. I showed Jay this Instagram bikini model, Sierra Sky, that my friend...
I don't know. Her hot, though?
She's crazy hot.
Crazy hot. I gave Lewis a bit... We have it up here, Lewis.
Lewis. So we have a... She has a video blog with her hot boyfriend, who's an idiot. And we've been watching their video blog.
Yeah. And now, are you guys of the mindset that all hot people have to be idiots? Because there's a few out there.
A few out there
are not idiots. There's a few good-looking people.
Sure, I actually talked about this with Dave earlier today, Dave Smith earlier today. I was saying, like, I'm not saying all of them, but I mean, if your life is built around your looks, you're pretty vapid.
Yeah.
It was all sort of born also out of, like, the conversation started about people having, like, no shame anymore and just, like, posing. Instagram has made everybody their own little celebrity in their own world. So how many people you walk by in a day, it's almost like you're numb to it. Like hardcore posing. I've been paying a lot of attention to it recently.
Yeah, taking pictures.
Like really posing in a way, it's like in the way of traffic or blocking a stairwell to something. Or just because it's important to them to take a fucking really posed picture.
2.6 million followers. She's done nothing except she's hot, right?
Yeah. Yeah, she doesn't. Yeah, that's her boyfriend Roman, who's also hot.
I think no one listened to a word I just said.
I know. I think you're right, and I think you caught Lewis up. That's the whole point of this: are they hot and have they had to form a personality? Some hot people have had to form personalities.
Look, I got to be honest. I said this.
I think porn stars. I always had the argument where David Tell said that if I wanted to ever host one of those porn star awards, the porn awards that. They won't laugh at themselves. They take themselves like very seriously. And to some degree they do, but I believe they can be broken down because even though their life is about being hot, they're broken people.
Yes.
If you're doing porn, you're a broken person. And you can get a broken person to laugh at themselves possibly and like
Yeah, well, to be honest.
But these people, she's pretty and just perfect. I mean, like, from her teeth, like, none of it's makeup and slutty outfits. Like, she's naturally unfucking real hot.
I will say this, though. Like, I am one of the people who do take a lot of selfies in public. Like, I have my penny board, my skateboard.
Yeah, you do a lot of Insta stories.
And I do some Insta stories while I'm on the board, and people get very angry behind me in the cars. They start honking their horns, like, you fucking dumb idiot, get out of the way.
They should.
And then I laugh at them, and I get them on camera.
And you go, get whatever you want, baby girl. So that was the scene where we're at right now.
Grab whatever you want, baby girl.
So this is them, and they're buying ice cold brew. You know what, Lewis? Finally, it does make sense. Lewis should have been born an Adonis. Lewis should have
or
been
a hot chick.
A hot chick or like a smoking hot dude.
I do have the obnoxious personality of a hot person.
Yes.
Without the physical appearance.
Yes. And it finally makes all sense why you're like, give me that. And I'm like, why is Lewis like this?
Get out of here. You're not good looking. Give me now. Move.
But I want it, though. It's mine. I'm pretty. I'm a pretty person.
It doesn't.
Big punk hits like you don't say no to a pretty person.
Yeah. Normal person. So they go into, we just showed them at their
Instagram model personality.
Yeah. they just,
Lewis has the personality of someone with booty implants.
Yeah. Lewis should be walking around going, drink fit tea. It makes my tummy nice and flat.
It's lit.
He goes, do you want these hair vitamin gummies?
Yeah.
With Christine. Hey, Christine. So they just left. They went into the, they left their friend's apartment and they're going to buy a cold brew. Mm-hmm. And this is where
it's
we
gotta be cold brew, brah.
What do you want, baby girl?
I want one of these.
Get the old school.
I don't like sweet on mine.
Okay, then should I get three? Or do you want
just get two. You one for you and Jackson.
How many? Her voice is it's terrible. Her voice is so hard to listen to because it's so high.
What kind of wine you want, baby?
I want the purple cane.
I want the kind that makes me sleepy. Can I have the sleepy kind?
Grab whatever you want, baby girl.
Yeah, what a great drop. Hit play.
Go cold brew nitro.
Yeah, nitro. All
right, so this is Jackson to go nitro.
Look at his eyes, though.
I know.
Look at those eyes.
Oh, God. Yeah. He's got wolf eyes.
He's stunning.
He's fine. Look, I don't know if he's stunning, but his eyes are stunning.
He's stunning. But here's the thing. I said Lewis, and I think you'll agree with this, too.
Lewis lit up when he saw his eyes.
Can you rewind just for a moment, please? Can we screen grab it, send it out to the fans on Twitter?
Oh, we've done this.
Oh, no, this is way too far ahead, because that's the part where...
The eyes.
Go way back, way back.
They sparkle.
Way back.
No, he shimmers like
Edward the
Vampire.
Go to 2 minutes and 45 seconds.
Oh, look at this.
There it is.
Like, there's just... Look at it. Look at the sparkle.
Yeah. Sparkle, Mr. Sparkle.
Oh, I'm a cold brew type of guy.
See, that's how good looking he is. Most people have to take a picture from above their head to be good looking.
Yeah.
He's so good looking, he can go from chin up his nostrils, and he's still better looking than everyone in this room.
Yes, in this room for sure, but that is actually not a very flattering look.
Hit play.
But here's the thing. Wait, before you hit play, and I'll say this, we were talking about this the other day, too, to Lewis. The thing about a hot guy, why the world's not carved out for him for sure, is because a hot guy really can't always fuck his way to the top, because girls are into very many different kinds.
Yeah.
Of quote-unquote hot guys, where as a hot chick across the board, like, everyone wants to fuck a hot chick, even if she's not your particular. I would always say I'm much more brunettes than blondes. Mm-hmm. If you're like, would you fuck this smoke? I'm like, who gives a fuck what her
hair
color
is? Well, here's the thing, right?
Sure,
it's actually a harder game for a hot guy, because a hot guy has to...
Are you speaking from personal experience you're speaking right now?
Oh, yeah. He's only going for the highest level bitch, okay? Now, those girls you're talking about have... Everybody in the world.
The bitches.
The bitches have everybody in the world at their fingertips at any given moment. So you have to be a pretty special fucking hot guy in order to get the bitch you want. You're going to get hot bitch.
You're losing all credibility just by leaning in, bitch. It's like
I'm Puerto Rico.
Oh, okay. Yeah. That makes sense.
So
all these bitches.
No, but I'm being
hungry for dick.
But no, I'm being honest with you. The hot guy, where it's not, it's great to be a hot guy. You're still going to get a hot bitch.
Yeah.
You're going to get the hot bitch that chooses you.
Yeah.
You're still getting the hot bitch that chooses you.
No matter what,
you're always the hunted, not the hunted.
Yes.
With a hot girl.
Or right not there. The hunted, you're just
the approval.
You got to get her fucking approval.
Yeah.
No matter, if you're fucking Johnny Depp, right? The chick you're going to fuck, she can choose any Johnny Depp she fucking wants.
Yeah,
she's
Amber
that
Heard,
high level. Yeah.
Amber Heard can go anywhere. Yeah. So, but this girl, Jacob's watched a lot of the videos. Jacob, you've watched multiple of the vlogs, right? I came in the office and you were watching it.
I love when they go to the Bahamas. They go to the water, to their friend's
Malibu
pool party.
That's when we were watching upstairs, where they go to the pool party. But Jacob has a theory that he's so dumb, he's wearing on her. And she's starting to like be like, I don't know.
Because she's realizing he's dumb?
Yeah.
Is that your dream fantasy, Jacob?
No,
you've been telling yourself
the
past 2 days?
Yeah, at the
but
end
I
of the day, she just wants someone who's smart and thoughtful.
I really wish I could find someone who can bake and isn't a NASCAR.
No, I just think she's getting bored. That's it. I don't think it's a matter of intelligence. Their lovemaking must be beautiful.
She can't get bored. Boredom's impossible for her.
I don't think that he knows how to program a radio show.
True.
And that's the problem.
True.
To be honest with you. If he had that skill set, I think she'd be way in.
Can you hit play, Christine?
Do you want me to go back to where they were shopping, though?
Yeah. Well, no, that was way far ahead. You jumped way far ahead for some reason. Because this is where we were.
That's Dan's way of calling you dumb when he says, for some reason.
I don't mean to be a rat, but Jacob cued the video.
I know. Jacob fucked up. I know which scene you were going to. You're going to the part
Sierra
where
Sierra was in the room, he wouldn't have fucked up.
He wouldn't have. Hit play.
He
Can I get this?
Yeah, grab whatever you want, baby girl.
That's Jacob's favorite thing.
Get the old school.
I don't like sweet on mine.
Okay, then should I get three?
Just get two. One for you and Jackson.
We got to get through and they get to the car. Just keep hitting play.
They're
don't
hanging
stop.
Out with Celine and Jackson.
They're hanging out with douchebags. Go cold brew nitro.
All right, so I convinced Jackson to go nitro. Like, every day I've been doing this and... I don't know. It gives me a certain feeling like I'm rushed up, like I'm amped for the day. So,
oh,
like,
God.
Why would you believe that? The fact that he believes people. Yeah, but everybody, they believe that people want to, like, this is available because it's on their social media. Like, hey, everyone, check it out. It's almost like you're just with us while we're doing the most mundane horse shit in the world. Cold brew nitro like a mofo. Totally got Jackson to get some.
I guarantee you this has more views than anybody's stand-up comedy in this room.
I guarantee it doesn't.
How many views does this have?
I guarantee it doesn't. That's it.
Yeah, she's got 3 million fucking viewers.
96,000.
That's still way more than it should for fucking idiots walking around a deli.
Well, Lewis, that's a good backpedal for what you just said, though.
What if they named it?
Look, no, I didn't know this was a YouTube video. I thought this was an Instagram video. Oh, and
yeah, that would have fucking smoked us.
Oh, yeah, I thought that one of her...
anything she posts, yeah.
Any one of her Instagram videos smoke. Yes. I mean, dude, are you kidding me? She has
sure, fucking...
Millions of fans.
But that's for the sexiness. This is like, hey, you see me be sexy. Now check out my work.
And watch
me hang out with the guy who is fucking me that you will never.
Who's also going to make you enraged when he's like, this is cold brew. I don't know what it does to me. I've been drinking it, but it makes my heart go pitter patter.
Yeah, it's like when I drink this stuff, sometimes I can't fuck, but I'll be like, hey, babe, just suck me off then instead.
And she gets me going, then I do want to fuck, and then I have a cold brew, and everything's all
right. Woo! Wake up late, do what ifs.
Yeah. I just roll out of bed into pussy. Legitimately, I make her sleep on the floor. Oops. She got a little bed. She digs it. Right, babe?
It's lit.
I can't be one of these. I get invited to, like, boat parties and shit sometimes. Like, stupid, yeah. like rich people fucking celebrity parties. Mm. And I won't go. I cannot go and be a person who, like, hangs on people with a yacht and be like, cool. Look how cool I am on this dude's fucking yacht.
Louis J. Gomez, Hollywood outsider.
Yeah. You heard it here. He's the outlaw.
I won't go to your yacht party, dick face.
Louis, there's so much hot pussy. And he goes, no, because I'm a beautiful person with integrity.
I can't stand on somebody's yacht. And fucking be like, dude, look how fucking, like, take pictures on somebody else's yacht like that's a weird. Fucking bitch.
Yeah, but you don't have to take pictures like that. You can just go on the yacht party.
I
must be social mediaing at all times. Yeah. What if I'm in a jerk off place?
Well, how am I going to Lewiscope? They're going to be like, why is Lewis not on Lewiscope? He must be at a yacht party.
Yeah, I know right where he is right now. Yacht party.
Oh, Lewis is. Let's get to.
Is that a yacht sound effect?
Yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah, Lou's good.
Lou's the shit. Doesn't it make you hate Bobby Hutch?
So weird, like, nobody...
It makes you hate Bobby Hutch because he never makes sound effects.
I thought it was a cow walking through a field.
No!
look at those eyes.
Do it again, and I'll make the ocean noise.
Shh. Can you actually just do a cow swimming through the ocean?
That little herd of cows just drowned in the ocean.
Someone shoot a nail through its head and kill it. Who's suffering out there?
They know about mortality. That's why they're worshipped in India. I bet you a cow would just fucking sink to the bottom and drown. Its eyes would pop out. There's no way to swim.
No.
Dogs can fucking doggy paddle. A cow would have to just fucking... Honk. Yeah. Straight to the bottom. It's hooves straight through the sand.
Just bubbles coming up. It's like...
I want to drown a cow as a social experiment.
Wow.
Yeah. Cool. That could be your science fair thing.
Yeah. He goes,
I'll do the tooth rotting in the Coke.
Yeah,
and then
I'll do how long cereal lasts in milk, and you kill an animal in front of a bunch of kids. And you, with that mercy.
I murdered a wolf with water.
Yeah, and turns out they don't like it like cats don't like it.
I mean, backup plan, here's a volcano I made.
So I took a baby giraffe, and I put his legs in concrete, and I threw him off a bridge.
I call it an East River Science Project. Let's do... Look at those eyes.
Jesus Christ.
When he gets to the car, it really gets infuriating.
Hey, Jacob. Jacob, you can get a cold brew, too. You can get a cold brew, too, if you want, baby boy.
Hey, baby boy, you want to come camping with us? Look at Jacob's eyes, really squinting up too. He's like, I wish this puss would. I wish this little queerbo. I wish this queerbo would make a move on me.
Bite this fuckface's nose off.
I'll be like, oh yeah, no, I'd love to go. Yeah, throw chop.
I go like this. I go, no, is that? Let me see what it says. That says Lucky Jack. Yeah, bite.
Hit point.
Throat bite.
Great OG. Made style. Bomb 'ems.
Oh.
It's lit.
A lot of people have that face. The kid, his friend, whatever that face is.
Jackson.
Jackson is not good looking, but he's rich and it hangs out with good looking people.
Oh, yeah, no, we know who he is.
There's a person that fits that exact category where they have, like, good products, but he's a fat fucking loser.
Sure,
but
you know what Jackson has, though? I'll tell you what Jackson does have. Access, because fucking Roman over here, gorgeous eyes.
Romo.
Has showed Jackson so many filthy videos and stuff of...
Sierra?
Fucking Sierra, just like, I mean, clam jam.
I don't think
I mean,
so.
Go, oh, yeah, yeah.
I don't,
yeah.
No,
Roman. Oh, yeah. You haven't seen Jackson interact yet.
No, Roman, I feel like he would only show that to people that could do stuff for him. He does stuff for Jackson. Jackson does nothing for Roman.
No, I think Jackson's got the car or something.
Yeah, Jackson's got to be the lackey.
Maybe his weed dealer.
No, I think Jackson
might be his weed
Jackson
dealer.
Jackson, this way good-looking people think, okay? Take it from one.
Yeah, from somebody with
the same way good-looking girls want to keep ugly girls around, good-looking dudes do the same shit, okay? Yeah. So he's his
what
fat...
What the fuck are you trying to say? I your fat Jackson?
No. You're Dan's fat Jackson. I'm Dave's fat Jackson. We're both Jacksons, Jay.
We're both fat Jacksons?
We're both fat Jacksons.
No matter what?
I just want to say, don't put Dave and I in the room, because, wow, what a gorgeous room.
We just start fucking each other.
you know, I guess there's no one hot enough here for us.
Jacob goes,
Jay's out of town next Tuesday. I figured Dave Smith would host, just you and Dave.
I can't do that.
Why?
I don't know. How do you want La Bamba-like sexual tension in this room?
Because it's going to get too real in this motherfucker if we do that.
How am I supposed to think of jokes when all the blood's in my dickhead?
Yeah. I go like this. I go, yeah, so this article, you look great, Dave.
Oh, I almost passed out.
Yeah.
So this week in news, I noticed that... Dave, that shirt is... Are you wearing that shirt, or is that shirt wearing you?
I go, wait, what are you... You got a new cologne, dude? Get over here. Why don't you grab on... Why don't you sit on the mic next to me?
So Donald Trump has said there is no
Wow.
Is that a... Are you hard?
Yeah.
I'm like, dick bulge?
I'm like, dude, I don't want to be weird, but do you want to do the next break, like... Johnny Cash, June Carter style, like on the same mic? We're just talking to Joe's face. I go, no, you go.
Yeah. He goes, I think these people are really attractive. I totally agree with you, dude.
You know what you guys should do? I guess more of a Legion of Skanks thing. We should all go on gay dates.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Like, with a gay dude, like the whole fucking date. You have to fucking go on the date.
I'll go on a gay
date.
The
whole time and see where it goes.
Well, I know where it's going to go, but what do you mean?
No, what, like you fuck the dude?
Oh, how good is the date?
No.
In fairness, Dan, he did just say, see where it goes. You don't have to fuck him. But if you want to fuck him, most of all, you can't fuck him.
It's really like testing your own boundaries.
It's like an old like sales like mentality of like, I used to tell when I used to train salesmen, I used to be like, you can sell anybody anything. Like, there's a series of questions right, and yes.
Are you saying we're going to get gay dated to bed?
I'm saying that there's a series of words that this gay guy could use to fuck you that he could end up inside of
you. He goes, Dan, what is the downside? I go, you have a very good
point. I have no idea. I'm letting you do me, so it's not even going to be painful for you. That's true. There is no pain involved.
This gay guy.
I have always seen gay sex is going to be painful in some way, but if I'm delivering it to this guy, it's not going to be painful.
Feels good if you think about
it, if I really close my eyes, I could probably, you could just pretend it's a chick. I'll shut my stupid gay mouth and be your chick.
Lewis is
all right. I am a chick.
I am a chick now.
Lewis is training gay guys how to fuck you. He goes, get rid of this pen, and the gay guy goes, done.
Oh. He just throats up.
If you buy my new book,
you got to be able to sell anything. Here, sell this skateboard. They just swallow a skateboard.
You can read Lewis's new book, Hey Bro, Fuck the Guy You Want, by Lewis J. Gomez.
The secret, in parentheses, I'm gay.
Back to...
How to fuck friends and influence people.
Back to Roman and Sierra's world.
Out here, and they're running some sort of game here.
Dude,
there's
first
these people
off,
here who happen... It seem like they're skin's darker than mine. I've never come across too many.
They're at, they walk up to a park. I'm going to preface the scene because I've seen this scene. They're at a park and people are doing those slam balls where you get inside in giant inflated balls and you run into each other.
Why have we not all done that?
No, we definitely need to do it. But watch the disdain on everyone's faces for Roman and not Sierra, because everyone, he talks and everyone's like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Shut up, bro. Let's just stare at your fucking chick's puss.
Yeah, watch.
Yeah,
play.
By the way, that's okay. Like, you can be around, but we all have to be able to look obnoxiously at your girl.
But watch, because he's obnoxious. So watch. He rubs people the wrong way.
Called bumper balls. Where they get inside these balls. And what do you guys do with it?
Hit each other.
You just run it. You just run at each other and get it. Can I get in one round maybe?
No, we paid for it. Sorry.
Oh, they're not letting me get in a round.
Oh, he sucks. I can't believe this six just fucking turned me down, bro. Won't you let me use your fucking battle ball, pig?
He goes, Jay.
You're probably not going to fit it anyway.
Ah, God damn it.
Let me use your battle ball. I'll let you look at me for 5 seconds.
Yeah. He goes, let me guess. You're in band in high school?
Check
why don't you give
out.
Me that ball?
Yo, let me use your battle ball. I'll give you a link to my private Snapchat for 1 month.
He goes, hey, you want my girlfriend to record you rubbing my stomach? He goes, she goes, we paid for it. He goes, yeah, right.
He doesn't believe for it. I know.
He goes, you know, I just bought it from you for a little bit of this. Just fucking pulls up the abs a little bit for a little bit of this.
And he winks. He goes,
we paid for it?
Yeah, dude, I know you paid for it.
Yeah. He goes, that's how
she keeps on calling him dude, or he keeps on calling her dude.
He goes, listen, all
right, bro.
He goes, all right, dude, listen, I just want to get in the ball, and I want to press my check, so.
We sort of paid for it. He goes, this guy won't let me get his battle ball.
Hey, bro, you want to go? I'll fuck you up right now, dude. He goes, whatever, dude, why don't you just go and play your video games?
I'm a former Division I soccer player.
He's like, yeah, sure, whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, whatever, me and him.
Yeah, D1, more like 1D. Am I right? This chick's got a duke.
Hit play.
All right, Jackson, anyway, let's get out of this fucking fag soup.
Let's grip it and rip it, Jack.
What?
So, she just got laid. Come on, you got it. Get back in the game.
Come on, out of here.
They didn't want me to play.
Yeah, they paid for it, you fucking moron.
Can you believe it? By the way, that is hot chick mentality when a girl's like, can I throw one of your balls on the bowling game? Yeah. You're like, well, I mean, playing a game of bowling, I can't just throw one. What's the big, it's not how it works.
By the way, it's the very similar to hot chick heckle mentality at a comedy club where they're like, I was helping.
There was a chick last night at the stand that was like laying and just like, oh, God, shut up with your.
I don't even try anymore. Can somebody hit her?
But
please.
You saw her, right? It was like a pretty girl, like a tall, big titted chick in the back with a good looking dude, and like everyone in the room just but every time she had a chance, she goes, oh, no, not just like making that, like, I'm saying it. Oh, yeah.
Me. It's a four. By the way, it's the way my son acts, because here's what happens. A 4-year-old will come up. Let's say we go to the park and there's 4 kids playing basketball that are like 7, 8 years old, right? My son will go up. And go up to them and go, can I have the ball? And the kids go, no. And then he'll start crying. He'll be like, why won't they share with me? And that's the exact mentality of every hot chick.
Yeah.
It's simple as that. They'll, no, I can
or
just
hot
take
guys.
This.
Yeah, because he went up and goes, what are you guys doing? He didn't even know this thing existed 5 minutes
ago. I don't think that if he didn't have her with him, I don't think that he would feel that confident.
Yeah.
Yay, with his boys.
I don't know, man.
Hit play. Now it's his dog.
Look, they're meeting each other for the first time.
These dogs look like that bitch in the battle ball.
He goes, hey, I'm going to reenact the scene from the park. Can I play your battle ball? All your nose is in your friend's dog butt.
Smell each other.
I don't want you to play battle ball, but why are you sniffing your friend's asshole?
It'd be great if that is how like hot dudes did meet each other and not fight. They just give each other and goes, what's up, blue eyes? What's up, green eyes?
Yes. You're okay.
Right. Okay.
You're, sweet. Right. You're from San Rafael? So you can smell a little different.
Ready?
All right, here we go. He starts his truck with a remote. Not that impressive.
Money.
So they're singing and dancing in the car.
Well, she's singing the wrong lyric. Can we rewind to her singing the wrong lyric? That's embarrassing.
Sierra, you should be embarrassed.
Look.
Money.
No, she didn't. Never mind.
She nailed it?
She nailed it.
Yeah.
She's perfect.
She is perfect.
Who just hangs out with a dude and his chick all the time?
A guy that's trying to see his chick naked.
Also, if you both like that queefy music.
Like, genuinely, he's not listening to her music. He's like, oh, can we put on that high, twangy, nonsensical bullshit?
He goes, babe,
do you know that I love?
Babe, can you put on the music that makes me feel like I don't have balls? Is there any of that? You have that ballless rock? There he goes, hit play.
Can you put on my Vag Fest mix?
Watch. He's like, kiss me. And the friend in the back's like, ah, don't look.
What a weird position to put that dude in. Yeah. Poor Jackson.
I'm starving. And Sierra gets really cranky when she's hungry, so I know that I need to get her. I know that I need to get her food.
Is he on a dolly?
So, yeah, I said you get cranky when you don't eat. So
he goes, I said you become a fucking cunt when you're hungry. She's like, Roman, they got real. Yeah.
I said you bitch out fucking hard like a twat.
Yeah, he goes, I don't know. Maybe you would fucking get off my case last time you wanted some Taco Bell. Get the fuck out of here.
Jackson, let's go.
Jackson's dumb bitch is hungry and I don't want to deal with her.
You really should piss off Roman. Come on, Jackson.
Yeah. Jackson goes, no. Roman's so mad. You know he's got his temper.
Sierra, stop pissing off Roman.
Just be cool. I'll make you feel better.
Hey, bro, it's lit.
It's lit.
Dude, your hoodie is so mad sick.
Yeah,
is it, bro? Thanks, Jackson. You always know what to say, bro.
Dude, thanks for being the wind beneath my wings.
Bomb ems.
Hit play.
Food ASAP. So let's get.
Is that him skateboarding?
Oh, he's awesome. I didn't realize he's awesome.
Dude, oh, that earring. That earring, rewind a little bit.
He only has an ear cuff.
Oh, dude. That bugs me.
I should.
Really crowded.
If you were in line, I'd be like, what the fuck are you doing, dude? Someone walks in with his hot girlfriend, and he goes, oh, so there's the line. This big-headed guy's here. He's breathing through his mouth. I'm all,
can you get me off your fucking Instagram, please?
I do not want to be on your vlog. Hit play.
It's so crowded here. I don't know. I think we're going to head out.
We were going to nitro up some more. How many iced coffees do they have to have?
Yes, I'm pretty much, it feels like I'm on PCP. I've drinking 7 cold brews.
Now he's crashing hard.
He goes,
I don't know, man. Everything hurts.
Like, maybe
the cops tried to arrest me. It took like 8 of them to take me down, but you know, I'm over a car. What are you going to do?
I think one of them shot me in the calf muscle. Well, anyways.
I just found out why this thing's called Mountain Gorilla Coffee. It made me go ham on this whole fucking town.
I have no clue where Sierra is. I hope she's okay.
I'm pretty sure I took a bite out of Jackson's shoulder. He left it pretty pissed.
I don't know, man. I drove my Dodge Charger into a crowd of people. I'm getting pretty crazy.
Things are getting a hit play.
So busy at every restaurant, and I need to get my little baby some food. We're at this spot called Shoots.
He's got a dick.
He's got to feed his dick.
He's a dick. Cool spot. Day.
Oh. Woo.
Catch you guys in a sec. Sausage.
Oh.
Babe, you want some sausage?
Get it? She goes, you're a fuck. Oh, this is the best.
Did he say get it?
No, I said get it.
Oh.
Watch this.
We're checking out. Is this your spot?
Is this your spot?
It's awesome. It's called, pronounced Shoops.
Shoops.
Oh, yeah, man. What do you recommend?
Hold on. Shut
Everybody
up.
Everybody hates him.
Go back, dude. Watch this guy's face. Watch this guy's face when he says, what do you recommend? Because he goes like this. He goes, is this your spot? The guy goes, no, I'm just wearing a chef's coat because I'm a fucking weirdo.
Dude.
He goes,
yeah.
All right. That's him.
It's lit.
Yeah, cool.
All right.
It's awesome.
It's called pronounced Shoops.
Shoops.
Hell yeah, man. What do you recommend?
You like smoked salmon?
Hell yeah.
I recommend you getting the fuck out of my face.
What do you recommend? I don't know. Maybe getting in front of the fucking counter, you clam?
He goes, what do you recommend? He goes, I recommend you get out of here before I grab that very sharp knife.
Before I meat tenderize your beautiful face?
I recommend you take your whore girlfriend and get the fuck out of the store and never come back here.
He goes,
Jackson, you can stay.
He goes,
thanks, bro.
Is this your place? The best part is he goes, you like smoked salmon? And then Jackson goes, fuck yeah! Jackson, watch. Jackson overreacts.
What?
Yeah, watch. He goes.
Hey, look at all those ones. The whole of them.
Oh, man.
We're checking out. Is this your spot?
Yeah,
I can't wait to try it.
Right here.
It's awesome.
It's called, pronounced Shoops.
Shoops.
Oh, yeah, man. What do you recommend?
You like smoked salmon?
Hell yeah.
I'm a fan. I do my own smoked salmon. Yeah. It's awesome. For Ashley's wrap, we're salmon BLT.
Okay. Salmon BLT?
Salmon BLT.
How is that fucking even possible?
And he goes, I'm sitting here and I'm wondering how the fuck he even does that. I think it's like, I think we walked into a wizard's den.
A fish from the sea and a pig on land. In fucking possible.
With vegetables. Dude, Jackson, check my ears. Is my brain bleeding? Because I have no fucking clue what's happening. Where's Sierra? I'm scared.
I love that we've opened the door for this, but we have to go.
That's dumb.
It's the end of a show.
Why?
Because we have to wrap it up.
Why?
Because it's the end of the show.
Why? And then we have to get ready for, we do a live show.
That's gay.
So gay, right? Luis J. Gomez, thanks for hanging out, buddy. Luis J. Gomez.
Legion of Skanks, obviously. Real Ass Podcast and Believe You Me, all available on the Gas Digital Network. Heard you guys are getting a new studio.
Yeah, we are. We just, we're signing a lease on Monday.
Congrats,
new studio.
Buddy.
Congrats, buddy. That's awesome.
Also, live show. If you're in San Francisco, I'm going to be the 27th headlining one night only at the Beer Basement, San Francisco, in the Tenderloin, GomezComedy.com if you want to get tickets. We got a weed sponsor, so there's going to be weed and fucking edibles and all
that's
that
awesome.
Shit.
That's awesome.
What, are we live tonight?
Yeah.
We're going to be...
Oh, yeah, we are.
Nice. So
Legion of Skanks live,
bitch.
Tonight. Dan, you want to come on?
Last night. You mean last night? Because this is Thursday.
It was live last night.
It was crazy. Jay had sex with a man on the show.
Did Dan do it? We'll never know.
Check it out, Gas Digital Network, and we will talk to you guys next week at the Bonfire SXM Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat. We'll talk to you guys later. Gators.
Just gonna send it.
Gonna send it.